Welcome back everyone to the series on working with the Syncfusion React Data Grid. In my previous video, I showed you the different selection options available in React Data Grid, including cell selection and checkbox selection. In this video, I will show you some of the useful customization options available for rows and columns in the data grid. I will also show you how to customize them using the template option. First, I will start with row customization in grids. I will use the example from my older video, Getting Started with React Data Grid. You can get this example from the link given in the description part below, or watch my Getting Started video from the card shown above. Here I bound the local JSON data to the data grid and displayed only selective columns using the column customization. Let's start with the customization now. First, I will show how to span the rows of data grid. To do this, you should know about the queryCellInfo event. This event will trigger before each cell renders in the grid, so that you can easily apply cell customization based on specific conditions. For this demo, I will set the row span of the customer ID column to 2 if the order ID is 10254. So I will create a callback function to queryCellInfo event. Check if the order ID is 10254 and the column is customer ID. Then set its row span to 2. You can see the row span is applied to the data grid. Now let me show you how to customize the row styles. For this example, I will highlight the grid rows that have freight value greater than 50. To achieve this, I will use the row data bound event. This event will be called while rendering each row on the grid. I will create a callback function and check if the freight value is greater than 50, and then apply a CSS style. To apply the green background to the row, in the app.css file, I will create a new style with background color set to green. In the output, for the rows that have a freight value greater than 50, a green background is applied. Similarly, if you want to change the background for a particular cell instead of an entire row, you can use the queryCellInfo event like this. Add the corresponding styles in the app.css file. Here I have used the getValue method to fetch the value of a given field. It's an inbuilt method available in ej2-base package. So I need to import this getValue method from ej2-base package. Then I have added conditions for applying different backgrounds for the cells. If the freight value is greater than 100, apply green. If the freight value is greater than 75, apply cyan. And if the freight value is greater than 50, apply yellow. In the output, you can see the different background color is applied for the cells with different values. You can apply custom templates for rows of the data grid. You can achieve this by using the row template property. I will create a callback function of row template and return the custom template. Here I will create a simple table with two columns. First column will show the customer ID and another column will show the ship country and ship date. You can get the row values through the parameter. Add the corresponding styles in the app.css file. In the output, you can see the custom template is applied for the rows. But note that the dates in the template are not properly formatted. To format them, I will use the internationalization option from the ej2-base library. Import internationalization from ej2-base. Initiate a new instance. And use the format date method to format the date to the desired format. In the output, the date is now properly formatted. You can also apply this custom row template as a detailed template. This will show the custom template when expanding a row. To achieve this, assign the custom template to the detailed template property. Now you can expand the row to view the custom template. Next, I will show you how to customize columns. First, let's look at column spanning, which is similar to row spanning. I have to create a callback function for the queryCellInfo event, and then I will span the column based on a condition, say if the ship country column contains the value France. This way, you can apply column span to the data grid component. Apart from these customizations, the data grid component also supports applying custom template design to specific columns. I will show you how to add a column that displays random images. I will add a new column directive with the header text set to image and then its width to 180, text alignment to center, and create a callback function for the template option. This callback function will return a random image. I am using the pixum.photos API to generate random images using the random ID and assign it to the image URL. In the output, you can see the additional column with the header image and displaying the random images in it. You can also apply a column template based on a condition. In this example, if the freight value is greater than 100, I will set the subscription to platinum. If it is greater than 75, set it to gold. And if it is greater than 50, set it to silver. I will add a new column subscription and create a callback function called conditional template. In the column function, if the value of the freight is greater than 100, it returns a span with the value platinum. If the freight value is greater than 75, it returns a span with the value gold. And if the freight value is greater than 50, it returns a span with the value silver. In the output, you can see the templates are applied based on the condition I specified. Let me summarize some of the major points we discussed in this video. First, we saw how to add row span and column span to the data grid rows and columns. Next, we saw row customization based on specific values in the row. We saw how to apply custom templates to the rows and columns. Finally, we saw how to render conditional templates based on specific conditions. Thanks for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.